So great, Sumala, I'll turn it over to you.
Thank you. So yeah, I'm going to talk about multi-fidelity and multi-scale Bayesian framework for high dimensional design and calibration. And I lead the AI guided design and materials discovery portfolio at our research center. All right. So in the engineering domain, real designs, the industry scale designs, such as let's say a gas turbine engine or a high temperature material discovery, these things take a long time, sometimes 10 years, sometimes 20 years. And a first half of that time generally is taken by the detailed design process, which involves very expensive simulations, data collection, and experimentation. On the other side, the next half is generally spent by testing and certification, calibration, and VNV. So the commonality between these two things, which take the time, is kind of, you can think of it as a mini query problem. So it interacts with the designer, bunch of solvers and data sources, like back and forth, and that takes the time. The iteration takes the time. So mathematically, we can actually think of it as a high dimensional, expensive black box optimization problem. So if we have a large dimensional space, maybe design variable or tuning parameters for a simulator, let's say that's X, and the performance on the top of it, or the output that we care about, the objective or the metric, that is function, F, and we have different sources from different discipline, the expensive multiphysics models, which can be nonlinear, discontinuous, and noisy. And also the sources might have different fidelities. For example, for CFD design, computational fluid dynamics, we can have a very simple 2D model which runs in second, but doesn't tell us about the turbulence much. But on the other side, we can have a large AD simulation running for days and weeks on GPUs or CPUs, and it can tell you a lot about the flow field. So you have this huge range of fidelities in the simulation. And generally these problems are subjected to multidisciplinary constraints, which are very complex and reduces the feasibility region to a very small area. And on the top of everything, there is the budget constraint, both compute budget and other resources. So we can think of this problem as a subclass or class of this Hebb optimization. To handle this, we have been developing a general framework, a machine learning enhanced design and discovery framework, where we are inserting machine learning at different stages of design. And we are building a domain agnostic framework, which can ultimately accelerate and give us better, more efficient product. So the machine learning here is basically doing a couple of things. One is learning from different sources like prior design program, physics-based models at different scales and fidelities and different discipline, and also tests like intelligently scheduled tests. And they're learning a meta model or a surrogate model. And then on the other side, machine learning is also trying to explore this high dimensional space by learning the surrogate model. And in this particular paper, we mainly focused on this middle swim lane, which is how do we learn from different fidelity of models and how do we kind of invoke those models in a budget constrained manner so that we can finish optimization under a certain stipulated budget. And we have deployed it into multiple areas such as materials discovery, aerospace design, and manufacturing process optimization. So, and the method, the particular method that we're going to focus on is multi-fidelity optimization. So there are two parts. We are learning multi-fidelity models, and also we are performing multi-fidelity solver sampling, like how do you sample different fidelity of solvers or data sources so that we can constrain the overall compute budget. To show the advantage, we can quickly see this particular 2D example, which is a Brannian function. And we have a high fidelity Brannian function, which is, let's say, the red color. And there is a low fidelity, which is, let's assume they're cheap, but there is a large error between red and blue. And we want to minimize this branding function, and there are a couple of constraints, simple product constraint and an island constraint. And the true optimal is actually the blue plus sign. So if we do a single fidelity optimization, just a sample from the red wireframe here, sometimes we don't reach the optimal point within a particular number of iteration. And sometimes we just get to other local minima because the feasibility region is really small. But when we do multi-fidelity, even the blue curve has large error. But if we still sample that, the multi-fidelity optimization basically exploits the inter-fidelity correlation and helps us optimize much faster, like within two iterations for the simple product constraint case and for the island constraint within seven iterations, whereas the single fidelity did not reach the single the optimal region. So what is this fundamentally? So we have two fidelities. It can be multiple, more than two fidelities also. One is generally slow, one is generally fast. Slow, expensive one is more accurate, fast one is less accurate, but we want to take both of them and learn a quantity of interest. And formulations, and historically there have been autoregressive co-kriging type of structure where you have a correlation term between fidelities and also discrepancy term. And we also worked on the nonlinear correlation between the different fidelities. So if we kind of go through this particular single one-dimensional case where the blue line is the true function and the purple line is actually the low fidelity function, even if it has large error, if we sample on the purple line, what we see that we can still find the blue line, the model, the blue line better. So basically even without sampling higher fidelity cases, we can still learn the function by exploiting the inter-fidelity relationship. Now, if the low fidelity is really cheap in compute, we can actually sample most of that and still perform a good quality design. And in generally Bayesian framework, the key function which controls the sampling areas, criterias, is called acquisition function. And acquisition function, there are a lot of innovation in that area. In this particular paper, we introduced few things such as multi-instance sampling to basically exploit parallel compute. So Bayesian frameworks are generally single point sampling. There are some batch sampling also, but they can be quite expensive. But here, depending on the clustering of the input and the acquisition function, we can actually sample very diverse points, instances, where we can run different fidelities. And that accelerates and uses the parallel compute much better than the state of the art. And also we handle different constraint types like inequality and equality constraint by adding this probability, like multiplying this probability of feasibility into it, and both for high fidelity and low fidelity. And also we handle the equality constraint by creating this tube around the equality constraint and slowly shrinking it in a scheduled manner as you go forward in the optimization. And for specifically for low fidelity sampling, we introduced this Gaussian process mutual information based sampling, which is kind of based on some prior work where people used mutual information for single fidelity sampling. And this particular formulation actually favors exploration in the beginning. And as you hone in on the optimal points, it favors more and more exploitation. And we have applied this all the sampling techniques into a global local setting where we generally go through a globally and find out different regions which are good in the design space. And then locally we hone in there. And we have two parallel threads. And this way we can actually do a very high dimensional surrogate assisted optimization much faster. For example, we applied it to compressor transonic rotor optimization with all the high fidelity models and low fidelity models. And we did much better optimization with respect to single fidelity cases at a 50 design variable. And we found very preferred blade design. Similarly, we applied it to multi-physics phase field model calibration, which generally takes months to calibrate from actual images, characterized images. Here we did it much faster with multi-fidelity calibration. So to basically conclude, we incorporated different information theoretic criteria for sampling and applied into industry scale problems. Currently, we're extending it to heterogeneous input data. There is a paper we have in NeurIPS. And also we're trying to improve robustness and incorporate higher dimensional reduction techniques in this. Thank you. Any question?